Hello students, Saina. I welcome you all to part 3 of chapter number 13, Fun with Magnets of your NCERT science textbook. As the name of the chapter is Fun with Magnets, in this chapter we are learning very interesting facts, fun facts about magnet and about the materials of earth which can be influenced by each other physically, like magnets attracting other objects like iron and some other metals. Before we begin today's class, let us have a small briefing of topics that we learnt in this chapter till now. We have learnt and understood that the definition of magnets first, then the purpose that the magnet serves, and an interesting story about the discovery of magnets. Then in online session, we have seen about the naturally occurring and man-made, or we can call that as artificial magnets. Then we have seen the different shapes of magnets and also about the magnetic and non-magnetic materials by understanding through activity. This much we have done. So children, what are magnetic materials? Yes, if a magnet is capable of attracting materials towards it, then those materials are magnetic materials. Example, nickel, cobalt, steel, brass, etc. are magnetic materials. Then we have seen what are non-magnetic materials. If a magnet is not capable of attracting few materials towards it, then those materials are known as non-magnetic materials. For example, plastic, wood, rubber, etc. are the non-magnetic materials. In previous class, I had a question about whether the soil is magnetic material or a non-magnetic material. Let's answer this question. Let us learn a few more facts about magnets by understanding another activity. And to know whether the soil is a magnetic or non-magnetic material, we are going to conduct a small activity. For this, you require a magnet. Rub that magnet on soil or sand. Then pull out the magnet. Will there be some particles of sand or soil that will stick to the magnet? If yes, then why? Now, slowly remove the magnet from the soil or sand and gently shake the magnet to loosen the particles which are actually not sticking to the magnet. These are the sand or soil particles actually which do not stick to the magnet, but there will be particles that will be still sticking to it. What are these particles, children? These are the small pieces of iron, commonly known as iron filings, which are already present in the soil. These iron fillings are mixed in the soil mixture and then get attracted to the magnet when magnet is picked up from the soil. So we can conclude that soil is generally a non-magnetic material, but some iron fillings are present in the soil which can stick to the magnet, which we call as iron fillings. Now children, we are learning this activity because through such an activity, it will be convenient for us to find out whether the soil and the sand have particles of iron present within them geographically. Now children, one more activity we will do. Try the activity that we have just learnt near your home or around your home or the places you visit on your holidays. But students, if we try to attract the iron fillings in the soil using a magnet, does the magnet look like any of these figures or images shown over here? Yes, children? Find out by trying this activity and also note down your readings in your notebook in the table shown over here, where you have to write the name of the location you have tried testing. And in the opposite to it, in the next column, you will write down your observation of magnet with iron fillings that are stuck to it. And what you are going to find out is, are many or are very few or none of them have been attracted by these magnets. That means here in the second column, you are going to write how much quantity of iron fillings which are attracted by the magnets. And this will let you know whether the soil texture is rich in iron particles or not at the area where you have tested. Now, we are going to learn about the poles of the magnet. Like we all have already discussed, a magnet has two poles. One end is the north pole of the magnet and other end is the south pole of the magnet. Let us learn why are they so peculiar. Students, have you ever tried testing a magnet to attract small iron or small metal objects? If you have tried, have you ever noticed any special or different in the way they stick to the magnet? let us learn that by understanding another activity. To do this activity, take a plain sheet of paper and spread it on an even surface. Then spread some iron fillings on the sheet. Now try to bring a bar magnet on the paper and place it in the middle. Do all iron fillings get stuck to the magnet all over its surface? If you observe the image, can you find more quantity of iron fillings getting attracted to only some part of the bar magnet? They are not completely attracted by the magnet and did not stick to it all over the magnet evenly. Yes, and why this is so? Try to notice the same activity again and again by repeating it for a few times. If you try it, then you will notice the same activity again and again. By repeating it for a few times, then what will you notice? Will there be any changes in the pattern in which the iron fillings get attracted by the different parts of the magnet? Observe it if you tried it. Like I have already said to you, if you do not have iron fillings at home to do this activity, you can try to do this activity by using metal paper clips or safety pins or iron nails also. Different shapes of the magnet, and even with these also you can try to repeat it for fewer times to observe any change in the pattern. That means, children, here instead of iron fillings, you can try this activity with the metal paper clips or iron nails or with the safety pins, and instead of a bar magnet you can use different types of magnet like U-shape nails or U-shape or horseshoe shape magnet or circular magnet or different types of magnet you can use for this activity. And children, this activity you have to repeat a few times to observe the change in the pattern. Students, to understand this activity properly, try this activity at home and draw a diagram exactly what you have observed to understand the way how the iron particles are getting stuck to the magnet. Compare your diagram to the image which I have shown you here on the screen and just compare it whether they are similar or not. Whether the diagram you have drawn by observing your activity is similar to the image shown over here or not. What we actually observe is the iron fillings will be attracted more at the regions closer to the two ends of the magnet. And these two ends of the magnet are called as the poles of the magnet. Poles of a magnet have the high capacity of either attracting any object or repelling it. But how are these poles located there? For that, try to take a simple bar magnet without any markings on it. That means a bar magnet on which the north pole and south pole is not mentioned. And children, check for the north pole and the south pole location on these bar magnets. We are going to use iron fillings. And children, now this activity we will do in our next class. Here, children, so the same topic I am going to continue in the next session. Thank you, children. Here I am ending this session. Goodbye.